want to create my own like gel art palette.
Close your eyes. Get some rest. I'm by your side. Lay your head on my chest.
This cute little table that I set up here for the different mediums that I'm going to be working with for the nail art workshop. We've got some dried flowers. This is going to be a tutorial showing you how to work with pigments. I pulled out some of my lace stamping plates here because these are both like lace and hearts, and I think these are what will work best for the workshop. Foils is another design we're going to work with. Nail decals, watercolor, of course. I do have some 3D embellishments here we're going to incorporate, some glitters. And then I pulled some different names of art inks. We're going to talk about the different varieties, like what might work better for how you work in your studio. And right now I'm working on striping tape. I do film with a microphone. I've been really trying to focus on my audio a little bit more because I don't know, I think I personally just have like sensory issues when it comes to audio. So I am trying to be a little bit more mindful of audio when it comes to my social media. I don't know, it's kind of like a hyper focus right now for my content. But I thought this little desk was so cute. That way I can just grab everything that I need and I'm ready to go.
By the time you guys are watching this vlog, the pre-sale is probably over, but you can still join the workshop. It's just the pre-sale pricing is done. So you'd be paying full price for the workshop.
Just about done filming for my workshop. I only have a couple more looks to do, but my desk is a mess. So I really have to tidy this up because I do not like working with this much stuff going on here.
I had a dream last night. Did everything I never do in real life. I stepped into a room, told everyone to be quiet, cause I had something to say, blew everybody away. Wear whatever I want, dressed in a gown, everybody's like, why, where you going, nowhere special, just going to the store. I think I'd have it all, tell you why, even more. Picking a plate, being a plate, she is unruly. Never seen her like this, didn't think it existed, no truly. She's not in a place, she'll get moody. But don't mistake this girl for being me, cause these are dream rules.
Like the worst, okay, maybe not the worst, I'm being dramatic, but I have so much like tooth pain. Ugh, it's awful. So I had a filling done back in December. It had like a filling fall out, so then they re-put it in. Moved on with my life, but it has been sore since. And anything I read, any when I talked to like the dental hygienist and everything, they had said that it can, like, the pain, not so much the pain, but like the discomfort could last up to a month. So I kept thinking, okay, like that's just what's going on. But it has progressively gotten worse to the point where I took so many ibuprofen yesterday. Anyway, so I was able to get in to go see the dentist today. I'm like dreading this appointment because I have so much anxiety about going to the dentist. I've never had like a super negative experience at the dentist, thankfully. I don't know, I just get so nervous because I know that like tooth pain is like, I've never really experienced pain like this before, but like even just after you get a filling done, like that achiness in your mouth, like I struggle with that pain so much. I'm so scared. So scared. So whatever. Maybe I shouldn't have turned the camera on today. I'm just like a basket of anxiety. I'm gonna finish getting ready. I feel like I look like a mom in the 90s. Right? Like you see those posts all over TikTok and stuff. I feel like, oh, that's what I look like. Okay, whatever. I'm gonna film my intro.
This drives me nuts in my videos, but it's like imperative to filming that it be like here. But like when you get your lighting figured out, you get your lighting down, you don't want to change it.
Trust me.
So I started a little bit of reorganizing on my desk. Nothing too crazy.
I just had this stand in the basement and I was trying to see if I could incorporate it into my nail desk. So I cleared out this little stand and put a lot of those items in there. And then this I want to use for like my content creating where I have, you know, my different swatches. And so I do know that I want my black, my white swatches. I'm missing having Q-tips at my desk. There's been so many times where I reach for Q-tips and they're not here. So I'm just going to fill this up with some items that I reach for all the time when I'm creating content. I have a lot of these in this stand. It's in a cart, kind of working, but I'd rather have them closer to me. Plus I'm like stress organizing. Sometimes you just gotta stress organize. And then these clear ones are actually like an almond shade, which I love. And if I had the time and energy, I would like re-swatch all of my Cocoa and Flair on these. But then I think, would I actually use those swatches? I don't know if I would. So then it just seems like time that I don't need to spend. Okay, I'm back. She said that they could not find like an abscess. Like it doesn't look like there's an abscess. But she's putting on antibiotics just in case. Then I'm gonna have to go see a root canal specialist. I'm so scared. I like started crying when she told me that. Like, will it be okay? Probably, but my anxiety is like, it won't be okay. While I was waiting for my prescriptions, I went thrifting. So I'm gonna go through what I got. Did pretty good for the kids there, actually. My little girl, one of my little girls loves little cardigans. So I got her this one. Got some more doilies. God, I'm such a sucker for doilies. But like, look at this one. It's like a double doily. I just appreciate all of the hard work that went into these. Love this pink one. Another little cardigan. And this, like, this is so adorable. How stinking cute is this? It's got these cute little pockets on it. My daughter's gonna love that. For my little girl as well. This one's a little big, but she'll grow into it. And then I found this sweater for me, which I was so excited about. It's from Torrid. And I just love the colors on it. Found these like wall sconces for the nail studio. I'm not entirely sure where they're gonna go. But I want to get some like battery operated candles to go in here. I've been on a hunt for like a napkin holder and this is perfect for my table setting. And I grabbed these corn dishes. These, I walked around the whole store and I was like, hey, you gotta go back for those. I just love these. I think these are fantastic. I have some fake fruit. I'm gonna put these in my kid's kitchen. I love the size of these. Violet is gonna love these. This one's got like grapes and oranges, strawberries, coconut, and then this one's more vegetables. It's got eggplants, tomatoes, peppers. This is gonna be so perfect for their play kitchen. It's a few days later. I'm not entirely sure where we ended off with our vlog. I think it was me going to the dentist. Anyway, I had to go see a root canal specialist yesterday, which I think I talked a little bit about my dental anxiety. Yeah, I needed to have a root canal done. He was like, we had a cancellation. We can get you in about an hour. And I'm like, oh, great. But also like, yeah, great. Please get me in. I was kind of thinking before I went to the appointment that I was going to need a root canal. So I was doing a bunch of like research on Google to see like what it was. And a lot of posts said that it's not much more harder than like a filling. And it was harder. The tooth that needed the root canal was a tooth that I had gotten done, like gotten filled, like a filling put back on it in December. And then ever since then, I've had nothing but pain. So like I had the filling, I can relate to what a filling feels like and what the root canal feels like. And yeah, they are not similar. it took 7 needles for him to completely freeze me, which I was not expecting, and I don't think he was either. It took a long time, like a super long time, and it was just like pulling and tugging on my teeth. He just basically just didn't have time to finish it. I left and I had the absolute worst pain of my entire life when the freezing came out. Like it was awful. To the point where I was like, okay, am I supposed to like call this dentist? Like why is this hurting so much? Eventually I got the pain under control by taking like more meds than I was probably supposed to. and was able to actually sleep. And then I woke up today and like there's pain today, but it basically just feels like what it did before I got the root canal done. And apparently I have to wait like 2 months before I can get the other part of the root canal done. Oh my gosh, this is just like, I feel like tooth problems are just like what my nightmares are made out of. Like I struggle with it so much, but whatever. We got about 80% of it done. So I have to get some work done because I was not intending on getting a root canal this week. So it's put me behind on the stuff that I need to get done.
That feels pretty messy. I've got my little heater here for this girl, so she'll actually use her bed. But I'm going to put it on the floor now, so hopefully she still stays.
You have a lot to do today, so it's a perfect time to do a project.
I do a lot of my content work on my phone, especially if I'm, like, waiting for an appointment, like, all this week. But just in general, like, it's just so convenient. Because I do a lot of typing on my phone, I find it incredibly annoying to just, like, type like this. Like, it just takes me forever. As somebody with ADHD, things that take a long time, like, procrastinate doing them. However, I found this little keyboard, this little guy. It was very inexpensive. I think it was like $17. Connects to your phone via Bluetooth. Once you've connected it, like, as soon as you turn it on here, it's just ready to go. Feels better than my Apple keyboard. Like, it's such a good movement, and I find that I can type up my captions just so much quicker on here. Speaking of random finds. So actually, this is not random. This was incredibly intentional. I don't know why I said random, but I picked this up quite a while ago. It's an empty like watercolor palette. You can get them on Amazon. They come with these little containers. I believe this one came with extra little containers too. And it's just empty. It's cute floral. And what I want to do with this is I want to create my own like gel art palette. I have the fusion paints. I have a lot of fusion paints. They would be my go-to like nail art paint, or the ugly duckling paints. I do really like those as well. I want to put my fusion paints in here. I think I'm just gonna do fusion paints. But I've been kind of like mentally struggling with how am I gonna get those paints in? Maybe I could just pour them, actually, now that I think about it. But I'm gonna go pick 40 paints to put in here, and then we're gonna fill this all up. Because I love those little gel paint palettes that I've seen people buy. There's a few of them out there now, and I have been eyeing them up for a while because I think it would encourage me to do a little bit more hand painting. And then I was thinking, you know what? You really like the fusion paints, and you should use them more. Get yourself like your own little palette. So that's what we're gonna do as our little project before I film. So don't despair. The gloves on because with all of the moves that these products have gone through, this floor is a mess. I wonder how many paints I have, actually. They discontinued fusion paints for a little bit, and then they eventually brought them back, and I honestly don't know if they've had like many new collections of them in a while. Is the paints too? Oh yeah, you are. They've changed their packaging. Oh my gosh. I'm just gonna organize them like by color family so that I can narrow down the ones that I want in my little tray. These are actually like really easy to organize because they're labeled as like red 101, red 102, so I can easily put all the reds together. Have about 68 gel paints. I can only put 40 in there. So now we're gonna have to open them all up and see which ones we want to put in our palette. Black 102 has a little bit of a sparkle. Black 101 is just plain. Okay, so you can make like a glitter palette if you wanted. That is not a red. What? How is that a red? 40 gel paints over here. Look at this, like it just made such a mess. I just really appreciate my desk cover here. It's a lot easier to clean this sort of stuff off of here. Make all the problems disappear. She could tell you the things you want to hear. She could read your mind and that you could laugh. All the little lies to tell yourself a lie. Never get it wrong, it's always right. Making a play, being a play. She is on a roll. She
I had an exciting package arrive. This is from Shop Blushing Rose. If you guys ever see play earrings in my earrings, in my videos, they're from Shop Blushing Rose. So she had like a, it was like a 75 or 60% off sale. She must just be clearing out some inventory. So I picked up a variety of different sets from her. And I thought I would go through them all with you guys. I wanted more like pink type of ones in my collection because I wear a ton of pink clothes, but I didn't have many pink earrings. So I got these ones. They're kind of like a corally pink. This neutral one, this one's just going to be good for like every day. And I loved these. I thought these were adorable. One thing that I've learned about myself with the earrings that I've bought from her is the really, really long dangly ones, I don't tend to reach for as much. So I believe I only got one, maybe two pairs of the really long ones. I just really like those little pine cones. Those are so cute. And then these little evergreens with some snow. You can get them with snow or without. Just little kind of neutral dangly ones. I wanted some more like everyday ones. These ones are have a little dangle with them as well. These ones are pretty long. I really liked the little flower images on them. And I have another set of these, but they're just all black and they kind of look like a sweater. And that's another thing about me is I don't tend to gravitate towards black clothing, black jewelry, like black accessories. It's just not me. I'd rather have like more color. So I know I really like the shape of these earrings, but I just wanted something with some more color. Another neutral set. And then these adorable like pastel rainbows. So I'm super, super pumped to have some new earrings. I made a massive, like massive mess of my desk here. Usually I have a little cart to put things away, but I don't have, this is my cart for products that need to be filmed or new products that I want to film, anything like that. And then I've got my big gray cart, which honestly can just, really, it's back there somewhere. Right there. The products on top just need to go somewhere. Like I really need a reshuffle of my nail art. This is an example of ADHD too. Just complete random tangents. It's like a heavy ADHD day. We will backtrack to what we started with. Eventually my brain will remember why I started this conversation. So these are like the Alex units. They, each drawer is not like completely full of art. Like that whole one right there can probably be condensed down to like half of an Alex unit. And then like a lot of my loose glitters and stuff, I love them, but I just don't use them very often. So I need to downsize my loose glitters as well. Also want to be able to get like all my hard gels in here. So I feel like once I shuffle this sort of stuff around, then I will know if I need any more storage units or anything. Because all of this stuff on this cart needs to go somewhere. But until I do the big shuffle of my nail art, I can't put this stuff away. So that cart is just like completely occupied by that stuff. So usually when I'm working, see, we made it back to why I started this. Usually when I'm working, as I complete a nail design, I will put all the products in my cart. I'll type up all the products I used, move them into my cart, and then my desk like does not get this messy. I don't let it. But when I'm having a bad ADHD day and I have nowhere to put anything, it just doesn't happen. Like my desk will stay like this. The good part about days like that is that I have content to film then because this desk ends up being an absolute disaster and it's fun to film like putting away all the products. So there's ups and downs to like the different days and how I feel throughout the month. So anyway, that's just what a random tangent that was. So just about done filming this part of the video and then I'm gonna spend the evening editing. That way I can get the video done and maybe even up tonight. Like, I mean, because it's like a heavy ADHD day, that means that I can hyper-focus like crazy. So I might be able to edit enough to get that video done. So you guys have these like little fake fingers, a really good way to clean them. It was just on the Clear Deli Stamper, like sticky pads. Just roll them on there. This one, I have like a dent in it. So it doesn't film the best, sadly. I'm gonna try it with this one. Sometimes like the little dent shows up and sometimes it doesn't. So I feel like this one will be okay. When I edit, I like to get super comfy. So I usually have a shawl on. Got my footstool, got my heater going. I shut the lights off. I just create like this environment of focus because if I've got like lights on and stuff, then it's just honestly so distracting all around me. I would like to get some
I don't want open flames in the nail studio for obvious reasons. Like, there's just so many chemicals in here. What they call them, like, wickless candles. But I just don't want them to look, like, super cheesy. So I'm hoping that I can find something eventually. But they're also super expensive on Amazon. So I was kind of hoping I could find some thrifting, but I have yet to do that. So I think those wall sconces that I bought are going to go on this wall here. And, like, that would just look so cute right now with, like, some flickering of the candles. But I gotta focus. I gotta get this done. Don't mistake this girl for being me, 'cause these are dream rules. This is someone else, I'm not myself, no, no. Okay, if you're wondering why I have so many keyboards, there's one here, right? This is my Apple keyboard, and I've been using Final Cut Pro for years for editing. It's what I know, it's what I'm familiar with, and I just find it way easier to use, like, an Apple-based keyboard for an Apple-based program, so I use this. However, I do not like typing long, like, emails or, like, words. Like, in general, I just don't like typing words with this keyboard. I like just doing, you know, my short commands and everything that I need for Final Cut. So I got this keyboard from Amazon, literally just so that I have, like, the clickies. It's got such a good feel to it. It, like, any boring tasks that involve, like, writing words and such, it gives me, like, an excitement to do that. And then we went over this keyboard too, so this one just hangs out at the bottom here. But this one's so light and, like, portable that I take it with me all over the house a lot of times. So in case you see multiple keyboards when I'm working, that's why.